Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, on July the 20th, 2011, Jamaica was stunned. A double killing over there in Lauriston, St. Catherine, involving a lady by the name of Charmaine Rattray and her 19-year-old daughter, Joyette Lynch, aka Crystal. When that incident went down, the nation was stunned. But in the news article, there was a brief mention of a young man by the name of Scott Thomas. He was 18 years old. Today I'm going to talk about Scott Thomas. I'm going to tell you who that really was. He was one of the most vicious youth Klansman ever produced. Right? They produce a lot. I know you keep hearing me say that, right? And you're thinking, oh, well, you say that all the time. Trust me. When you talk about an organization where if you have four or five bodies by your name, that ain't nothing. Right? I'm going to talk about Scott Thomas, this youth. According to the police have him linked to over 30 murders. That is also the police them know. Scott Thomas used to brag about the real number. But before I go any further, I just want to say special birthday shout out to General Wise from the Patreon squad. Big up yourself, bro. More life, more health, more wealth. Stay safe, right? Now, people, you might be wondering, because people message me, what happened to the video from yesterday? The video was briefly taken down by YouTube. Right, them flag it because in the video I was talking about obviously 11-year-olds and 9-year-olds and 3-year-olds. So, and then you hear me, there's a part in the video I mentioned about private parts and everything. The YouTube system, which is controlled by robots, I guess they never understand the context. So them say, me I talk about Pitney, and me I talk about private parts, and you know. So basically, them flag down the video. But then I appealed it, and then a human being actually review. And understand the context when we use it, you know. Right, so of course I had to do some editing, right, but the video is back up, people. If you want to know the story about Yummy Sandifa, you can just Google him and you will see him. Right, now back into this video. People, Scott Thomas. This youth had a specific name inside our clans. Within the system, and when you hear me say the system, I'm talking about, that's what clans call for them thing, in terms of how them organize and how them distribute guns and how them collect extortion money. It's called the system. Within the system, this youth was given a name to show you how ruthless he was. His name was the Witness Killer. Scott Thomas, little boy, right? Start was the gun for him here, little youth, was called the Witness Killer. Anytime Klansman used to have nobody, any witness to them hear about who might go testify against nobody, this was the youth who go for them. Now, over there in Lauriston, right, James Hines, who, to be honest, that brother probably needs his own video, right, James Hines, that youth was one of the pioneers of the whole Flingway thing, right, and the last time I said one of the pioneers, somebody messaged me, yeah, but that man did it first. Okay, one of the pioneers doesn't mean you're the first man that HTV cut off my head, right. It just means that GM Hines and them, and they, of course, you've heard about Hodges. For them thing was, for them specialty was to take off people's head. They could do it very quickly as well, right? But after James Hines dropped out, Larry Standard really started to get run by a brother named Crab. This is another Crab now. This Crab real name is Jerome Williams, right? You have Crab, Sci-Fi, who I mentioned from the Chaliga Park video, and Scott as a young youth, and them really did have one up the place. Scott, when you talk about Chaliga Park, when you talk about all, you see, enough of them shootings that were like going over at Chaliga Park and inside with them, in the war at the time, Scott, Sci-Fi and Crab and them, and they did a lead those operations, right? Put it to show you how serious the man them was, when James Hines dead, them keep a party in a Chaliga Park to celebrate the fact that James Hines dead and Crab. And sorry, Scott and Sci-Fi them go over there, go shoot at the party and kill man. Right, that's how happy people were that James Hines gone. But I'm say, if you make a picture of James Hines, I'll do a separate video on that. Terrible, terrible youth. Right, as I say, I don't know if he go some kind of medical school, but that youth was very quick when it comes down to the remove editing. Right, now, Scott was a youth who, his mother passed away from illness, right? And him going at the system very young. Klansman love to recruit them very young, right? Because, as I say, a part of the whole badness thing is that youths who go on the conveyor belt, they often tend to want to feel to be a part of something, right? And Scott felt a part of a system that rated him. He was rated highly. Tisha Miller love Scott, because Scott was that type of youth like Jay, but them you don't understand the word no. If you say go for somebody, them gone. Scott, I'd used to brag, say him at 18 and him triple in birthday in our bodies. Do the match span that. That was theme bragging thing. When my 15 in brag say, yo, my triple in birthday, and when my 16 in brag say him triple. When him did that all the play him at 18. That's how many bodies him say him. The police can only link him to 30. Right? But you know, if police can link him to 30, then the real figure is much higher than that, because there's some of them that's not gonna know about. But one of the reasons why Scott was so deadly was because he was literally a look youth. And theme style was so weird, khaki. Right, he used to put on him khaki and go up and theme ups them, and he would just walk past police. And at the time, the police them never know what him look like. People remember way back in them time, yeah, police never know only for picture and only for this and the man. They only used to hear man name, and unless somebody actually point out say listen to him, they not gonna know. So Scott did a carry out a whole heap of killing at the place. When you talk about Greendale, when you talk about, as I said, Tea Park, Gravel Heights, Thompson Pen. Enough of the killing them when they go on over them side, they Scott and Cypher and them and they do it. And they used to do it and walk right back past the police them. There was an incident where Scott them go up on the ups down the old road. And them see two youth a bleach late in the night. Right, every time the youth them spot Scott and the man them a come, the youth them run off. And Scott them to the team say, where you run, girl? One other thing, you know? And one of the youth them stop and say, oh, one other, you say? And turn back. And the next youth say, yo, me I got my bed, you know? Because I know who them man, you know? So me I got my bed, and so one turn back and one keep going. The one that turn back, as he reach up to them, the man didn't kill him. Right? There's a next incident where there's a female taxi driver who used to run upon Thompson Pen Road, and Scott just up like a schoolboy going at the lady taxi. Normal like so just ride him and take. And as he come out of the car, as he reach him and go and come out of the car, him just start with that woman. Right, that same woman, the man that made up kill off a whole heap of her family. Right, I think only one or two brother left back. Because the man there at the time, if I go for one, it can't be one. If I go for the rest, and if you say, y'all call the name, then you say, oh, all the others murmur, grumble, just give them a reason, let me come for you. Bear in mind, when I talk about a little boy, you know. And when you hear some of them things, sometimes you might be forgotten things, and say, I think about some big old rusty season, 87. No, when I talk about a little youth in that age, right? Very young youth, Scott Thomas. Oh, and before me even forget, Scott was also a part of the Tradiga Park operation, right? Because there's no way that could have missed him. And people, after the Tradiga Park incident, it did get to a point where the man then basically started to take over. Because remember, what confused a lot of people is that them things say, because people know Tea Park as a place where is a labourite place, as a one other. Now people never realize, say, they get to a point where clans did eventually start to muscle them way into it, because even Larry is in the name place there. Right, there were some people in Lariston who were really resistant towards Crab and them and James Hines, because there was a time when, believe it or not, Lariston was a cool place, and it's really James Hines and Cypher and Scott and them and they come really turn out the place and make the place get hot. The man they killed out whole heap of people under the disguise of the whole informatic. Right, them time they, when they want to get rid of somebody, when they see anybody in the community who are going like them, they want to accept clans as the you know, as the, I guess you could say the people who in charge, then them that was run the informer care. That's the number one trick where clans used to get rid of people. Informer. When them branding with that, then that them have all the reason to go get rid of you. Right? But as me say, in the war with Ansem, because Ansem was a man who Ansem they done switch bank clans already. Right? And him that move from Tradiga Park, then he move to Waterloo. So none of them place there where people are drop like fly. It was really Scott, Cypher and them and the Ula really mash up the place, right? And as I said, not this name, people who come from them community, they remember this name very, very well. However, I have to put it out there. In Lariston, Scott himself wasn't actually that hated, right? You see, because he had this little boy thing about him, right? And the people them did really, even though I know this sound crazy, but compared to the other clansmen, he was seen as one that was at least approachable. Because again, we're talking about a boy. He was a little boy, right? So imagine living in a community where you're a big man, 40, 50-year-old, and you have your answer to all one 17-year-old. But people rather deal with him than Crab and them, who were seen as more dark and, you know, more arrogant and less approachable. But the people then used to help him, right? So anytime police, when the police them finally started to figure out who is this crab brother, anytime the police them left out from people's jeep, I go anywhere over that side, they might call Scott. So for a long time, Scott was evading the police. And even time the police were on upon him, and them questioned him, nothing happened because nobody was coming forward. Partly because some of them did, as me say, and they seem as good compared to Crab. I know that sounds extraordinary, but imagine living in a situation where people have to choose between a Scott Thomas or a Crab. Right, as me said, this is the Jerome Williams Crab. People that say, well, we don't want to get rid of Crab, we don't want to get rid of Scott, because if we get rid of Scott and police gone with Scott, then I've got to deal with Crab. Right, so people that help look out for him, the people them really shield him from the police. Police bring him in and ask him all kind of questions, try time to all kind of murders. Even some of them doing a broad daylight. Nothing could stick. Nothing. This is why I'm telling people, listen, when this man walk out a case and bust case easy, get locked up, and then have to get let go by police, it's because they don't have a case. Scott wasn't no big time money man who could buy out none. It wasn't that. Then nobody was coming forward. Nobody was going to testify against them mutely. As me say at the time, the man have Larry Stan hat. Crab had a saying. Crab used to tell people, say, listen, by the time them don't need Larry Stan and them place there, I just the ants and the roach them are left back alive. The man not killed a whole heap of people. Any resistance, the man like get rid of them. Those some people understand who Scott Thomas was. He was one of the most loved youth in the system, Tesha Miller. When they talk about Golden Boy, he used to have some youth that Tesha Miller does love. Scott was one of them. He have a youth, Demar, his nickname was Baby Killer. Him started shooting people from about 13. Right, that Demar, him in jail right now. So you have to understand, people, get the idea of who Scott Thomas is. Because in tomorrow's video, when I talk about Charmaine Rattray and her daughter, you're going to hear some things will go down as to how Scott lost his life. And I know Jamaican people, I know they love the mourning for 87s, especially when you see them get a rough going out. When you not hear how Scott go out, you just have to remember who Scott Thomas was and how dangerous as at 87 he was in the streets. But the real part of the story that is key is the fact that it's Scott Thomas' death that triggered what happened to Charmaine Rattray and her daughter. So in tomorrow's video, I'm going to tell you how the man named killed Scott. And I'm going to show you how a kerosene played a major role in this disaster. And it truly was a disaster. I know that everybody who suffered from the whole name calling and false accusations and all them things, the kerosene is one of the few people who walked away untouched. People don't want to hear that video tomorrow morning. That's going to be a big one. The narrative about the Charmaine Rattray story about how them said they might inform and people that say what Tesha Miller said, trust me people, the narrative that is known to the public is not the real story. Tomorrow morning, we're not going to hear the real story. They're going to blow up people's mind and they're going to show them how people are wicked. They're going to show them how a kerosene oil can be wicked. Tune in. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. People, stay safe.